All right, let's try this. Your line, just say it as I say it. Say your line exactly as I'm about to, just as I'm about to do. Would that it were so simple.
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 My dear boy, why do you say that? Why do you say twer?
Well, you should say it like I said it.
Would that it were so simple.
Would that it were so simple.
Would that it were so simple. Trippingly.
Would that it were so simple. Trippingly.
No, don't say it trippingly. Say the line trippingly.
Would that it were.
Would that it were so simple?
Star Wars might have the most toxic fan community out there. There are people who love the original movies and hate the prequels, and people who think the prequels are fine, and even others who think the prequels are the best of the series. No matter your opinion on the films before the Disney buyout, the films after the Disney buyout have all been met with a lot of love and a lot of hate. No matter what I write on a Star Wars movie, I'll get a response attacking my opinion. So, do I love or hate the latest Star Wars entry? My review may be the most controversial of all, as I exited this movie with a resounding meh. If you followed the stories behind the scenes of this movie, you'd know it was an absolute shit show. I have to admit, the idea of watching a Han Solo prequel movie did nothing to excite me. However, when I heard Phil Lord and Chris Miller, the team that made the Lego movie, would be directing, my interest in the project rose. Then the duo had a falling out with writer Lawrence Kasdan, a writer I respect a lot. They were fired and replaced with Ron Howard. Howard is a competent director who was supposed to direct a Star Wars movie back when George Lucas still had the rights. On paper, this seemed like an acceptable change. Then you take into account the fact that we're dealing with a Han Solo origin movie that no one is really interested in, and the guys now in charge are known for doing a good job, but not known for adding their own unique spin on something that shouldn't work. The behind-the-scenes mess doesn't blast through like other messy projects, but is very much there. Much of the movie is dedicated to fan service, giving origins to things that don't really need origins. Ever wonder where Han Solo's last name comes from? It also sets up the seeds for future Star Wars standalone movies that no one was asking for. The highlights come largely from the cast. Donald Glover does a spot-on Billy Dee Williams impression that works in the same vein as Carl Urban's DeForest Kelly in the new Star Treks.
Okay, then. Are you out of your Vulcan mind? Now back home, we got a saying. If you're gonna ride in the Kentucky Derby, you don't leave your prized stallion in the stable.
Woody Harrelson works as a thief and smuggler that Han Solo ends up working with. Phoebe Waller-Bridge works well as one of Lando Calrissian's droids, L337. Unfortunately, the negatives then appear way too often. Alden Ehrenreich is a serviceable Han Solo, though he brings nothing new to the table and doesn't hold a candle to Harrison Ford. Emilia Clarke's Kira is supposed to be the love interest, but her and Ehrenreich have barely any chemistry. Quite frankly, I can't blame the actors for this. Kira is written as such a nebulous character, so she can simply do whatever the script needs her at any one time. And finally, the story. It feels like a breakneck series of heists, with just enough connecting them to barely make any sense, but just barely. Solo is a film far too concerned with setting up Han's character in future Star Wars films than it is telling a solid story on its own. Howard does a fine job directing, but there's only so much that can be done when a studio is clearly controlling the project. If you are absolutely desperate for more Star Wars in your life, Solo is your best option. Everyone else can skip this movie.
Why the pout?
Ha! Would that it were so simple.
Hey, if you like this video, please make sure to hit that like button and go ahead and subscribe. That helps me out a lot. And if you really love this video, consider visiting my Patreon page.